example, some are multicellular, some are unicellular, and also they use different modes of reproduction. Some use asexual reproduction, some use sexual reproduction. And the asexual reproduction is the one in which single parent is involved and do not contain the reproductive cells. The offsprings formed by the asexual reproduction are the exact photocopies of their parents. Generally, unicellular organisms like bacteria, viruses, etc. use such kind of mode of reproduction, that is asexual reproduction. They multiply themselves by the asexual mode of reproduction. These organisms reproduce by fission, fragmentation, regeneration, vegetative propagation, budding, and spore formation. Now, first is the fission. When a parent cell divides into two or more daughter cells, is called as the fission. It contains a binary fission and a multiple fission. Binary fission is the one in which a parent cell divides to form two daughter cells. For example, in the amoeba or the Leishmania. And the multiple fission is the one in which the parent cell divides to form multiple daughter cells at single time. For example, the plasmodium or the malarial cells. Now, the fragmentation. When a parent cell divides into fragments and it forms a new organism from each fragment, this is known as the fragmentation. For example, the spirogyra. Next is the regeneration. As its name suggests, if a part of a body is lost, then it can grow a new one. For example, the tail of a lizard or the planaria. Now the next is budding. A new organism is formed on the parent body in the form of a bud. And when it grows and becomes mature, after maturation, it detaches from the parent body. For example, hydra. Now the vegetative propagation. When the plant grows asexually from their vegetative part is known as vegetative propagation. They grow from their stem, roots, leaves, buds, etc. The plants that grows from the leaves are the money plant or aloe vera, and the plant grows from their roots are the carrot, radish, beetroot, etc. And the plants that grows from their buds are the bryophyllum, and the plants that grows from their stem are the very common examples with the sugarcane, rose, etc. Now, the last one is the spore formation. The organisms belong to the fungi group, produces spores in a sac-like structure called as sporangium. They produce the spores and it spreads into the ground and the air and produces the new organism. For example, the rhizopus. And if you like the video, please share the video and subscribe to the channel.
For more such interesting stuff, subscribe to our YouTube channel.